So let us see this problem number 21. A particle of mass m is fixed to one end of the light spring of force constant k and mass related length l. The system is rotated about the other end of the spring with an angular velocity omega in the gravity free space. As shown in the figure, the increase in length of the spring will be. What to find increasing length due to the circular motion? So actually, last year in 11th standard we have seen the chapter mechanical properties of solid, and in that case we have studied the property of elasticity. So due to the elasticity of the spring, when the body is straight, body is pulled down, means when length of the spring increases, then due to the elasticity, restoring force is acting, and that is given by K, force constant multiplied by elongation produced. So that relation is now required. So I will show the arrangement like this. Suppose this is the radial support from where the spring is suspended like this. So this is the original length, unstraightened length, it is used the symbol L. Now this is the original length L. A mass M is suspended here. Now due to this gravitational force, so its length will increase. So this block will be here. So this is the elongation x, and now this bob is revolving in a circle. So radius of the circular path r will be equal to l origin length, unstraightened length, plus x elongation produced. Where to find x? X is equal to question mark. So in this position, there are two forces. One is a centrifugal force, and other is a restoring force due to the elasticity of the spring. So when there is an elongation produced in the spring, then restoring force is acting like this. It is directed toward the center O, toward the fixed support. So this is the situation. So x is the elongation force due to the centrifugal force. It is a gravity free space, therefore there is no effect of gravity. So let L is equal to unstretched length of spring, that is before circular motion start. X is equal to elongation produced in the spring due to centrifugal force. I will let down completely. Due to the centrifugal force of circular motion. Therefore, R is equal to L plus X is equal to radius of the circular path. Radius of circular path. So, during circular motion, of the body, of mass m, centrifugal force due to circular motion is balanced by the restoring force. Restoring force acting on body of mass m due to elasticity of the spring. Elasticity of the spring and then CFF is equal to restoring force. So this is given by mr omega square and this is given by k into x where x is the elongation force. So this is the basic equation. Now substitute r. R is equal to this m into l plus x. Omega square is equal to kx. Kx like this. So open the bracket. M into l into omega square plus m into x into omega square is equal to kx. Is equal to kx. So we're going to simplify this equation. So we have to find the value of the x. X is the elongation force in the spring. So we have to find x like this. So this term of x is taken here. So m into l into omega square is equal to kx minus m into x into omega square. So x into bracket k minus m omega square is equal to ml omega square and therefore x is equal to m into l into omega square by k minus m omega square. This is the value of the elongation force in the wire. So the correct choice is B. B is correct. B is correct. Right. So this is the correct answer. So elongation product depends upon mass of the body m. It also depends upon the original length and it depends mainly on omega. Omega is the angular velocity of the circular motion of the bob like this. So here we are using the property of the elasticity. When the spring gets extended due to the elasticity, restoring force is acting which tries to bring the body to its original position when the length is L. So L is the original length, L plus X is the new length. So this X is the elongation produced and larger the elongation, more is the restoring force produced due to the elasticity like this. Next. Question number 22. I will read the problem. The string of a pendulum of length L is displaced through 90 degree from the vertical and released. Then the minimum strength of the string in order to withstand the tension as the pendulum passes through the mean position. So the condition is like this. Again, I will draw the figure. This is the pendulum, this is the initial position. In equilibrium position, it is in the lowest position. Now, it is taken to 90 degree. So, this angle is 90 degree. and now it is in the mid position. Now when it is released from this position, 90 degree position, then it will come down, so it will perform vertical circular motion. Vertical circular motion. So there is a change in the tension in the string when it goes from M to L. So that change in tension should be such that there is no breaking of the string. So the minimum tension, the minimum strength of the string is equal to change in the tension from M to L. This is the main requirement. Also, when the bob of the pendulum is released from horizontal position M, it perform vertical circular motion and passes through lowest or mean position L. The bob continues circular motion without breaking the string if this is the condition. The minimum tension, minimum strength or tension the minimum strength or minimum tension withstand in the trim is equal to change in tension from position M to L, and therefore this is equal to TL minus TM magnitude. So TL is equal to 6 MD, TM is equal to 3 MD, and therefore antar is equal to 3 MD. This is the antar. So the correct answer is C choice is correct. Is right. So, here the value TL is equal to 6 MP and TM is equal to 3 MP. The value cut is ready up to half a moment. TP is equal to MG cos theta plus M BP square upon R. So, this is equal to TL is equal to MG cos of 0 plus M into VL square upon R, where VL is equal to root 5 VR, TM is equal to MG cos of 90 plus mvm square upon r. Mvm square upon r, where vm is equal to root 3 dr. तो हा वैल्यू सबस्टिट्यूट केले की टीएल की वैल्यू 6 एमबी आणि टीएम की वैल्यू 3 एमबी आपण प्रूव केलेले आहे आणि हायेस्ट पोटेंशियल ला टीएच इज इक्वल टू 0 होतो. ओके, सो द टेंशन बेअर इज इक्वल टू दिस 3 टाइम एमबी, बेअर एम इज द मास, एम इज द मास ऑफ द बॉल, ऑल एम इज द मास ऑफ द बॉल लाइक दिस. So let us see this next problem 23. Problem la start kele apan te tari particular property apala ithe use karava lagel. A boy hurls a stone in a horizontal circle of radius 1.5 meter and at height 2 meter above the level ground. The string breaks and the stone flies off tangentially and strikes the ground after traveling a horizontal distance of 10 meter. What is the magnitude of the centripetal acceleration of the stone while in circular motion? The circle madhe firat asana the centripetal acceleration of the vicharlela aahe. So AR is equal to centripetal acceleration, AC is equal to question mark. So the situation is like this, madhe problem open that example aahe. या स्ट्रिंगला आपण इकडे एक स्टोन लावलेला आहे आणि आपण असं फिरवत होतो सर्कलमध्ये, तर हा स्ट्रिंग ब्रेक झाला की तो टेनेन्शियली फ्लाय ऑफ होईल आणि तो अगोदर हॉरिझॉन्टल जाईल आणि प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन जी काही झाली ती आणि शेवटी काही डिस्टन्स गेल्यानंतर तो ग्राउंडवर होईल. सो दिस इज अ ग्राउंड लेवल, लेवल ग्राउंड. सो a boy was a stone at height h, so this height is h, h is equal to 2 meter, this radius r is equal to 1.5 meter. Now, when the string breaks, the stone flies tangentially like this, and it will perform this projectile motion. So, this stone has covered this much distance. Horizontal distance covered by the stone is equal to x. So, at this point P, where to find centripetal acceleration? This is the stone of mass m. So you have to find the centripetal acceleration. When stone is in circular motion, when the stone is in circular motion, its centripetal acceleration AC is given by v square upon r. So this is the equation mark. त्यातला r तर आपल्याला डायरेक्ट दिलेला आहे, म्हणजे v काढायचा आहे. सो v इज इक्वल टू tangential velocity. Tangential velocity with which stone flies off. So v is given by x upon t. this is the x distance covered in horizontal direction. V is equal to x by t, where t is equal to time taken to fall down under gravity. Under gravity through height h. आपण एखादी बॉडी जर इथून डायरेक्टली सोडली तर ती ग्रॅव्हिटेशनल फोर्स मुळे या डायरेक्शनने त्याला इथून ग्राउंडवर पोहोचायला जो टाइम लागेल तोच टाइम इथे पण लागतो. टाइम चेंज होत नाही. मागे आपण प्रोजेक्टल मोशन मध्ये असे प्रॉब्लेम सॉल्व्ह केलेले लागतील बोर्डच्या बुक्स मध्ये. सो वेदर द बॉडी इज फॉलिंग डायरेक्टली डाउनवर्ड फ्रॉम एच हाइट टू झिरो हाइट और इफ इट इज मूविंग फ्रॉम द दिस ट्रेजेक्टरी projectile motion, it will take the same time. Therefore, this h is given by h is equal to 1 half dt square. Therefore, t square is equal to 2 times h by g. So, 2 multiplied by height is equal to 2 upon g can be taken as a 9.8 term. Or, it is given 10. So this is t square. Therefore, t is equal to 2 upon root 9.8. So this is nearly, this is 3.1 something. So this is equal to, I will give the value directly, 0.64. Second, this is equation 3. Therefore, put into, so velocity v is equal to, the horizontal distance covered is equal to 10 meter. Check from here, it covered a horizontal distance of 10 meter. So, 10 upon 0.64. So it will be 100 upon 6.4. The answer nearly 15 and 16 temple is, I will give the value directly. It is 15.62. Long line answer to me check kara. 15.62 meter per second. This is equation 4. And now use this value here. Put in 1. Therefore, AC is equal to V square upon R. So, V is equal to 15.62 multiplied by again 15.62 upon radius is equal to 1.5. So, this comes to be 163 meter per second square. B and C is equal to. So this is near, it is more than, this is nearly 10, so this is multiplied by this 10. So answer would be more than 156, and more than 156 is only A. So AC is greater than approximately 156. Therefore, AC is equal to 163. Meter per second square. Therefore, A is correct. Rough calculation of the calculation. Complete calculation is so hard. How 1.5 is happening? 15 is divided by 10. 10 multiplied by this, so this will be 15.62. The value 10 is greater than 156. And 156 is less than 162. All remaining choices are less than 156. Therefore, B, C, D are wrong. So, this is about the प्रॉब्लम आहे हॉरिझॉन्टल सर्क्युलर मोशन, नंतर प्रोजेक्टल मोशन, मोशन अंडर ग्रेव्हिटी, बऱ्याच प्रॉपर्टी आपण कंबाईन केल्या. एट इज इक्वल वन हाफ डीटी स्क्वेअर, दिस इज द इक्वेशन फॉर द मोशन अंडर द ग्रेव्हिटी लाइक दिस. सो एट इज इक्वल टू 2 meters, देयरफॉर वी कॅन फाइंड द टाइम. नाउ इन दिस टाइम डी द बॉडी कव्हर ए हॉरिझॉन्टल डिस्टन्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू 10 meters, देयरफॉर वी कॅन फाइंड बी. अँड वन्स वी नो बी, वी कॅन फाइंड बी स्क्वेअर अपॉन आर. आपल्याला बी स्क्वेअर अपॉन आर कॅल्क्युलेट करायचं होतं. So when the string breaks at point P, the particle goes tangentially with velocity v. So this v remains same. We know this property. When the centripetal force becomes zero, then circular motion will stop and linear motion along the tangent to the circle will start with the same speed. And v change hot nahi. Circle madhe phirat asthana jo kai speed hota, to speed सर्कलमधून बाहेर पडल्यानंतर टॅनेन्शियली जाताना असणार आहे तो. सो व्ही इज अ व्हेलॉसिटी इन दिस डायरेक्शन, हॉरिझॉन्टल डायरेक्शन, अँड इट कवर्स ए डिस्टन्स एक्स इज इक्वल टू 10 meters इन हॉरिझॉन्टल डायरेक्शन इन टाइम टी सेकंड 0.64 seconds. सो एक्स बाय टी विल गिव द व्हेलॉसिटी अँड दॅट व्ही इज सबस्टिट्युटेड हियर लाईक दिस. हे 2-3 steps आपल्याला करावे लागले इथे. So let us see this question number 25. 24 we have already seen with problem number 15. 15 and 24 both are having same theory. So we will see this next problem, 25. A car wheel is rotated with uniform angular acceleration. Problem मध्ये थोडंसं correction करून घ्या. With uniform angular acceleration about its axis. Initially its angular velocity is zero, means it is at rest. It rotates through angle theta 1 in first 2 seconds, and in next 2 seconds it rotates through additional angle theta 2. The ratio of theta 2 to theta 1 is ratio nakkit ekapeksha jyada yenare, karan angular acceleration chi value zero nahi. So speed is increasing and therefore theta 2 will be more. पहिल्या 2 सेकंदामध्ये कमी अँगल कव्हर केला जाईल, नंतर त्या 2 सेकंदामध्ये ज्यादा अँगल कव्हर केला जाईल. चला सर. सो द प्रॉब्लेम इज लाईक दिस. सपोज दिस इज द व्हील. This is the center O. Consider the point P. Consider the particle P at time t is equal to 0 second. Now, P1 is a position when it covers the angle theta 1. So this is at time t is equal to t1 second. Now at time t is equal to t2 second, say the particle goes to p2. p2 is the position at time t is equal to t2 second. So this additional angle covered is equal to theta. So this t1 is equal to 2 seconds, t2 is equal to, this time is 4 seconds, total time 4 seconds, 2 plus 2, 2 plus 2 that is equal to 4 seconds. We have to find theta 2 by theta. The main condition is angular acceleration alpha is constant. So at time t is equal to 0, इनिशियल एंगुलर वेलोसिटी ओमेगा वन ओमेगा जीरो इज इक्वल टू जीरो, दिस इज ओमेगा वन, दिस इज ओमेगा टू, एट टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो इनिशियली ओमेगा जीरो इज इक्वल टू जीरो केस नंबर वन, इन टाइम टी वन सेकंड ओमेगा इन टाइम टी वन इज इक्वल टू टू सेकंड ओमेगा इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा वन इज इक्वल टू थीटा वन अपॉन टी वन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा वन माइनस ओमेगा जीरो अपॉन टी वन, सो ओमेगा वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू थीटा वन अपॉन टी वन डिवाइडेड बाय टी वन, देयरफॉर अल्फा वन इज इक्वल टू थीटा वन अपॉन टी वन स्क्वायर, दिस इज इक्वेशन वन. इन नाउ वी विल कंसीडर द टोटल टाइम from initial position. In total time t2 is equal to 2 plus 2, in total time t is equal to t2 is equal to 4 second, omega is equal to omega 2 is equal to total angular displacement is theta 1 plus theta 2 upon T2 and therefore angular acceleration alpha 2 is equal to omega 2 minus omega 0 upon T2, so omega 1 is equal to 0, so theta 1 plus theta 2 upon T2 square, this is equation second. Since alpha is equal to constant, therefore alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2 in first t1 second, in total time t2 second. So using 1 and 2, so alpha 1 is equal to theta 1 upon t1 square is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 upon t2 square, and therefore t2 square upon t1 square is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 upon theta 1, and therefore left hand side is t2 upon t1 whole bracket square is equal to 1 plus theta 2 upon theta 1, but theta 1 dogana pan separate divide, so t2 is equal to 4 second, t1 is equal to 2 second, so 4 by 2 bracket square is equal to 1 plus theta 2 upon theta 1, so this is equal to 2 square minus 1 is equal to theta 2 upon theta 1, so 4 minus 1 that is equal to 3 is equal to theta 2 upon theta 1, so this is the answer, theta 2 upon theta 1 is equal to 3. पहिल्या दोन सेकंदामध्ये जेवढा अँगल कव्हर केलेला आहे त्याच्या 3 टाइम्स ग्रेटर लार्जर अँगल सेकंड 2 सेकंदमध्ये कव्हर केला जाईल, टाइम सारखा दे 2 सेकंड 2 सेकंड. असे प्रॉब्लेम पण लिनियर मोशनसाठी पण यूज केलेले आहे. सो द करेक्ट आन्सर इज सी, देयरफॉर सी इज करेक्ट. So check the problem. In first 2 seconds, the particle moves from P2 P1, angular displacement is theta 1. In next 2 seconds, it covers additional angle, for total time 2 plus 2 इथ यू नीड 15 टाइम 2 सेकंड फॉर 2 प्लस 2 4 सेकंड एंड टोटल एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज इक्वल टू थीटा 1 प्लस थीटा 2. सो रिमेंबर दिस सेकंड केस. सेकंड केस मध्ये बऱ्याच वेळा चूक होते. फ्रॉम पी टू पी वन टाइम टी वन इज इक्वल टू 2 सेकंड. फ्रॉम पी टू द टोटल टाइम इज 4 सेकंड एंड टोटल एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज इक्वल टू थीटा 1 प्लस थीटा 2. सो ओमेगा 2 इज इक्वल टू टोटल एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट थीटा 1 प्लस थीटा 2 अपॉन टोटल टाइम सेकंड टी टू इज इक्वल टू 4 सेकंड. सो टी वन इज इक्वल टू 2 सेकंड टी टू इज इक्वल टू 2 प्लस 2 टोटल टाइम इंटरवल इज 4 सेकंड. Answer will be more than one. So see this figure. Figure is important. The particle is performing circular motion in anti-clockwise direction. So P is the initial position at time t is equal to 0 where angular velocity is 0, means body is at rest. Now in time t1 is equal to 2 seconds, it covers the angle theta 1. In next 2 seconds, it covers the angle theta 2. So theta 1 plus theta 2, total angular displacement shown by red color is theta 1 plus theta 2, total angular displacement in time 2 plus 2, total time 4 seconds. So omega 2 is given by theta 1 plus theta 2 upon t2. Omega 1 is given by only this. Omega 1 is equal to 0 initially at rest. So this is theta 1 upon t1 square. This is theta 1 plus theta 2 upon t2 square. And since the condition is given, angular acceleration alpha is constant. Therefore, in time t1 second, angular acceleration is alpha 1. In time t2 second, angular acceleration is alpha 2. But angular acceleration is remaining same. Therefore, alpha 1 is equal to alpha 2. Using 1 and 2, we get this relation. Next problem, 26. So I will read the problem. An object is being weighed on a spring balance moving around a curve of radius and diameter at a speed of 7 meter per second. The object has a weight of 60 kg weight. The reading registered on the spring balance would be. तर हे जे 60 के जी वेट आपल्याला दिलेलं आहे ते त्याचं ट्रू वेट आणि मोशनमध्ये असताना तर ॲपरंट वेट आपल्याला विचारलेलं आहे. तर लास्ट इयरला आपण ग्रॅव्हिटेशनच्या चॅप्टरमध्ये एक रिझल्ट बघितला होता. वेन अन ऑब्झर्वर ऑफ मास से 50 किलोग्रॅम इज स्टँडिंग इन ए स्टेशनरी लिफ्ट इट्स ट्रू वेट ऑन द बॅलन्स इज 50 के जी. मग वेन द लिफ्ट मूव्ह अप there is an increase in weight. When the lift moves downward, there is an apparent decrease in the weight. So apparent weight is less in the downward motion. Apparent weight is more in the upward motion. And when the lift is stationary, there is a true weight. He motion is the linear motion in lift madli. It is circular motion upon it clearly. When the apparent weight is value, not 60 kg weight, nahi, not 60 kg weight picture, jada hai. Iba begli. Allah. So what is that reading? So all the reading are 60 point something. आपल्याला accurate calculation इथे करायला पाहिजे. So the situation is the like this. Figure of मत की suppose this is the rigid support. This is the spring balance. And this is the weight attached. M. So in this case the spring balance shows the true weight. Now this bob is taken sideways and it is rotated in a horizontal circle. So now the bob is here. So in this case the true weight MD is acting in this direction. This is the position of the spring balance. So this is the true weight MD. MD इथे जेवढा आहे तेवढा तिथे पण असणार आहे. But Now, due to the circular motion, there is a one more force acting in the direction. So, this is a centrifugal force. Now, if you complete the parallelogram, then R is a resultant force. So, the spring balance will record R, and R is more than mg because it is the diagonal of the parallelogram. When the antar 60 peksha jyada hai na, 60 kg weight peksha jyada hai na. So, this is the spring balance. Case number 1, before circular motion starts, reading of the spring balance is equal to m into g is equal to true weight. True weight. Equation E. The lift stationary is the original method. Second case. Second case. When the bob of mass m perform circular motion, then centrifugal force is acting radially outward. Therefore, R is equal to resultant force of MD and centrifugal force equal to MV square upon R. This is the R. Like this. Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, R square is equal to mv square plus mv square upon r whole bracket square. So this is the value. So we can make the calculation like this. So this is equal to md bracket square. This is also m. mv square upon r multiplied by d divided by d. Therefore, mv square into bracket 1 plus v square upon rg bracket square. This is the value of r square. And therefore, R is equal to mv under root 1 plus v square upon rg whole bracket square. V square upon rg whole bracket square. Like this. Upon v square upon rg value separate from u. So this is equation 1. So equation 1 shows that R is greater than MD, R is greater than 60 kg weight. So we will calculate this V square upon RG separately. V square upon RG is equal to 7 multiplied by 7. The values are V is equal to 7 R is equal to 100 and E is equal to 920. So this is equal to 49 upon 980, that is equal to 1 upon 20. 1 upon 20. Therefore, V square upon RG whole bracket square is equal to 1 upon 20 whole bracket square is equal to 1 upon 400. 1 upon 400. And therefore, this is the equation second. Put 2 in 1. Put 2 in 1. So R is equal to MG multiplied by under root 1 plus 1 upon 400. So M is equal to 60 multiplied by 9.8 multiplied by under root of 401 upon 400. So this is equal to 0. So this first value is 588 and this second one root has a value, the root ki value jara apan kar lete hain 1.3 antar tumhe calculate kara di 1.0025. So 588.0. So he will look at his root. So 60 multiplied by 9.8 multiplied by this root is 1.0125. This is in Newton. Therefore, R is equal to 60 multiplied by 900 multiplied by 1.00125 upon 9.8 kg weight. G cut to together. So 60 multiplied by 1.00125 and therefore R is equal to this answer comes to be 60.075. This is the correct answer. The reading of the spring balance. Reading of the spring balance R is equal to 60.075 kg weight. A calculation dara check kara. Therefore, the correct answer is A. A is correct. A is correct. The lift upward direction is the another source of weight water factor, gain in weight. So, sir, prepare. E table of the element. So, this figure shows that. In initial position, undeflected position before the circular motion start, the balance will show the true reading, true weight mg. Now when the bob starts circular motion, then centrifugal force will add and the resultant force is the resultant of centrifugal force and mg. They are perpendicular, so we can find this resultant R by Pythagoras theorem. So R square is equal to mg square plus something, therefore R is greater than mg, R is greater than 60 kg weight, so answer will be more than 60. If the territory choice more than 60, then we have to accurate calculation.
जेईचाच प्रॉब्लेम येतो. जेईला तसं एका प्रॉब्लेमला 2 मिनिट्स टाईम दिलेला असतो, त्याच्यामुळे कॅल्क्युलेशन आपल्याला फास्ट करता यायला पाहिजे. ते तर फिगर जरी कोनिकल पेंडुलम सारखी वाटत असली तरी आपल्याला रिझल्ट जरा वेगळा पाहिजे. इथे बॅलन्सचं रिडिंग विचारलेलं आहे, म्हणजे या बॉबर ॲक्टनरी रिझल्टंट फोर्स पाहिजे आर. सो द स्प्रिंग बॅलन्स विल रेकॉर्ड द वेट इक्वल टू आर. आर इज द रिझल्टंट फोर्स ऑफ एम जी अँड सेंट्रिफ्युगल फोर्स अँड इट इज गिव्हन बाय दॅट पायथागोरस थेरम लाईक दिस. ओके, विल स्टॉप हियर. सो वी विल सी रिमेनिंग प्रॉब्लेम इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. प्रॉब्लेम जरा काही लेंथी आहे, तुम्ही स्वतः पण ट्राय करा पुढचे प्रॉब्लेम, तुम्हाला पण एक आयडिया येईल. ती नुसतं सरांनी तर प्रॉब्लेम सॉल्व करणार काही मजा नसते, हा लक्षात. काही कॅल्क्युलेशन तुम्ही जरा कम्प्लीट करून घेत जा, ते चेक करून घेत जा. ओके, विल स्टॉप हियर.